Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Ankit Sharma and I am a 3D character artist for games and movies. So today in this video, I am going to start a new course series on real-time hair creation. In this course, we will understand how grooming works in video games and what are the important factors we should take care of while creating a hair for a game character. So let's first understand this. Character creation can be anything. Character creation can be anatomy, it can be clothing, it can be hard surface, or it can be hair also. So the basic of character understanding is same for every part of a creation. So in this course, we will understand how these core things applied and what are the important tips and tricks we can use to create a real-time hair. And I also tell you about the industrial standard pipeline and resources to produce a real-time game-ready hair. So for that, you have to just subscribe this channel and save this playlist because you are going to get a lot of things in this course. Now before that, some of my friends were asking some basic questions about the creation process, like what is grooming in character? What should be standard polycount for AAA games, specifically hair only? What are the standard polycounts used in creation of hair? And how to place these hair cards on character? Or what map should I bake? How much time will I spend on one game assets and all? So these are the basic and general questions and every artist are aware. And I will tell you and I will answer the all these questions. So for that, please save this playlist. And I know this is introductory video, but believe me guys, you are going to get a lot of things in that. So before starting, let's understand our main target or our main benchmark in term of quality, in term of skill we are going to learn. So here you can see on screen, this is ArtStation and these are the all professional artist and their artwork. So we are going to reach at that level. So at that level in term of quality and in term of skill in real-time hair creation, these are our industrial game development hair standard. So in the game, these kind of hair are used. So we have to create this kind of skills. And I want to say the demand of grooming artists is increasing in game industry. Because there are limited resources to learn this kind of skill, but you don't worry. I'm with you and I will help you to learning this skill. So just follow some step and process. I will guide you step by step with all the pipeline process of creating real time hair. After that course, you also can create this kind of AAA game ready assets and build a awesome portfolio regarding a grooming as in grooming artist. So as we decided our benchmark, this kind of hair quality we need for game development for gaming industry, so we will create this kind of hairstyle in our course. And these are the industrial standard, and after this course you can also create your own game ready hairstyle assets. So after that, I will teach you the standard pipeline of hair creation for gaming industry. Like I will teach you how to understand this kind of details in hair, how to get this kind of flow and this kind of hair silhouette, these kind of volume in hair, how to create this kind of heavy volume and those beautiful hair shaders you can see on screen. And at the last and but not least, we will maintain a standard render setting and many more. I will using a Marmoset or Unreal Engine for render purposes. So this is first part of this course. This is introductory course, I know, but you have to save and subscribe this channel because you are going to get a lot of things. So let's start our reference project. Here you can see this is our main hairstyle. In this course, we will work on this hairstyle model. And I know this is very beautiful and very complex hair flow you can see here. So I choose this model because in this single course, you can learn a lot of things in a single project. I mean, here you can see the amount of flow it has, the amount of silhouettes, amount of volumes in here, and this kind of hair shader combination, hair clumps, the hair bun style, and that hair braid formation, and many more. So you will get lots of things in single course and single playlist. So that's why I choose this model, and I will create this hairstyle using hair cards. So let's talk about real time hair. So first we understand what is real time means. So the real time means that something is going live. Something is going live into a specific environment, game environment, realistic environment, this kind of thing. So we have to call this real time hair creation. So there are two basic variations in hair creation, like cinematic hair and real-time hair. Cinematic hair, which is called a pre-render hair. Mostly those rare hairs are used in movies and VFX category. And real-time hair, which are used in video games, because here we encounter a real-time environment, near-time objects, real-time situations and all. So here we call it real-time hair creation or real-time character. So here we are talking about real-time hair for games, so which is going to live in game environment. So basically you should take care of one thing. In game character creation, it is not about just create a beautiful character render and just put on your portfolio. It is not like that. Because in games, character needs to do a lot of things, like character has to move, character has to jump, character has to fight, run, and a lot of things. So we have to create a animation ready character. Animation ready, what does mean? The character has a specific poly counts, character has a specific flow, edge flows, and that kind of situation where the animation can support. So here we have to create this kind of animation ready character, animation ready polygroups. And so the hair part is very important aspect for the animation, because it has to be withstand in every situation with the game environment, with character. So that's why we have to understand the proper pipeline within this limited poly count for hair. So for that deep understanding, what we have to study is, we have to study real human hair, like what are the type of hair, how they react in different situation and different environment. So we have to study the real time hair of human hair. So for that deep understanding, what we have to do is, we have to study real human hair, like what are the type of hair and how they react in different situation and environment, how they grow, how they flow from root to tip, and this kind of basic information we need to understand in, as in a human hair. Before that, I want to ask you a simple question, which is very important for character creation, character design, and which is very also important for your decision making, how to proceed with your character. So what is the first thing you notice in any character or any reference that you are going to work on? What is that first thing? After that, your direction of character creation will decide. So what you say? That important thing, what is the first thing you notice on every person or anything that you start to create this kind of thing? So this is very important. You have to understand this. So if you know the answer, please write down in comment section. So let's move on. Let me tell you the answer. The answer is gender. Yes, it is very important, but it's very obvious, I think. But gender of a character is very important to know first, whether it's male or whether it's female, because after that you will be able to take a decisions on lots of aspects, like body shape, clothing, hair type, itself, and many more things. You are going to take a decision based on that answer, like gender of a character. What is the gender of a character, whether it's male or female? I know this is very obvious, but very important in term of creation, because as you can feel, or as you can observe, the female shape has curves and male shape like a box, sharp structure. Female has smooth forms, curves in every aspect, like in term of anatomy, in term of hair flow, in term of curves, in term of clothing. So female has a curves and male has a sharp, strong, square type structure. So for that, this decision is very important to make, and this is very important to understand before we go into technical or any further creation process. Now move on with the hair type of a character. Like, there are four type of hairs in general. You can see straight, wavy, curly and coil hair. You can see these four type of hair, and there are different type of different way to create these kind of hairs. Let's take an example. Like, this is coil hair. You can see, and we can create this by using hair tube workflow in Maya. This is a workflow creation technique which are used in Maya. I will teach you in this course. So what we do is we take a cylinder and we create a tube like structure, and we just placed on the specific place to create this kind of volume and silhouette structure and hairstyle like that, and we just place a map on this tube. So we can create this kind of rounding coil effect on head. There are lots of techniques and workflow and process to create this. I will cover all this in this course. So the next step is hair placement on character. So before that, you have to understand the flow of hair. So what is flow in hair creation process? So flow means how hair grows, where it start and where its roots come from and where they end. I mean, how they create their clumps, like how they create their flow from top to bottom, or if it has any bun. So how to create this kind of bun, how to move the hair clumps around it. And to know that, it will help you to create a hair guides and modifiers in 3D Maya. So to understand this, you have to draw it. Just draw it. Draw this hair flow on a reference image itself. Just get an idea for your Exyn hair guides. I will tell you what is Exyn guides. It's like a hair plugin which are used in 3D Maya and which is used to create a hair. So just try to draw those hair flow and how they start and how they end, how they curves, how they silhouettes, and this kind of thing. Just draw on by yourself and identify the flow of hair, identify the hair clumps and how they find the hair volumes. It is used to find a negative space in hair, and different layers are in this hairstyle. Try to differentiate it, how they created this kind of bun or this kind of hair, specific hairstyle. When you draw by your hand or by your pen on screen, you will get to know that this is a way to place a guide or place a hair guides on model. And once you draw all this information, then it will help you to place any hair guides, as I told. So let's moving on, and this is a basic introduction for this video, and this is basic understanding of this course of creating hair cards. And before that, you have to understand basic of hair, basic of hair type, and basic of situations that their hair are performing, like a real time environment in games. So all that you have to understand this. Now moving on, and I will tell you the course syllabus, what we are going to learn in this course series. So now let's talk about the syllabus of our course. In this course, we will start with the introduction of hair workflow and process. I will introduce you with the Exyn plugin, which is used in 3D Maya for hair creation. And further that, I will deep down into Exyn guides and modifier to introduce you some basic information about our guides and Exyn modifiers on a small project or a small sphere kind of. So we will create some hair clumps, and we will also introduce you to the hair tube workflow. And after that, I will introduce you to the ZBrush tools and sculpting of hair part on model. Then in ZBrush, we will sculpt in details of hair clumps and braid and our bun, hair bun, and those small transient hair also. So with the help of these sculpting, we will get to know the how volume our hair has. And after that ZBrush sculpt part, we go into a Maya and bake our hair maps using our node render. In this part, we will create a hair shaders in Maya and render out our desired maps like AO maps, depth map, root map, normal map, and specular, roughness, direction map, ID map, and many more. So these are the maps are used to render out our desired hairstyle or hair color, hair shaders. So when we export all the maps, then we go for our hair card placement. We use ZBrush and Gizmo transport line. This kind of tool ZBrush has. So with the help of these tools, I will place our cards in a desired hairstyle manner. After the hair cards placement, we will go into our render settings and Marmoset or Unreal Engine, and we'll import our hair cards and model to export a beautiful render of our hair shaders. Here we create our hair shaders, and we can also modify our colors, shades, roughness, and all kind of settings we will introduce with the render settings there also. So this is it. Let's move in with second video. We will sculpt our hairstyle in our next video. Thank you so much for watching and keep learning. This is first part. This is introductory part, and which is very important for our understanding, deep understanding of creation process.